नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रोफेसर एस लाल, प्रोफेसर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स एंड कंप्यूटिंग इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द नेक्स्ट पोर्शन ऑफ टोपोलॉजी एंड इन प्रीवियस क्लास यू हैव गॉन थ्रू द बेसिक्स ऑफ टोपोलॉजिकल स्पेस and the three conditions. You saw that how a topological space is going to be formed. So let us see. I am sharing the screen. We have already discussed topological spaces, metric spaces, and today we are going to discuss the basic topology. Let us see this basic topology. So please start writing what is basic topology. As you are seeing on your screen, that if you have a set X and a basis for a topology on capital X is a collection of capital C of subset of X called the basis elements, such that for each small x belong to capital X, there is at least one basis element of capital C belongs to epsilon containing X, and if X belongs to C1 in intersection C2, for two basis elements C1, C2 belongs to C, then there exists a basis element C3 containing X, such that C3 is the proper subset of C1 intersection C2. Just we are giving a very small twist to the fundamental concept of, you can say, topological space and the conditions you have taken there. The same conditions are here also. We are also talking about the union and intersection of the sets, but here the basis of our discussion is the basis. So you should remember this first line with the second line. Means first and second conditions are very much important for you on the basis of topology. Means if someone is asking you, or if you are supposed to explain that what do you mean by basis of a topology, then you should explain this. And once again, I would like to suggest you that you should once say in your algebra that what is the basis. Okay, basis, where there is also basis, so you should see the concept of basis from there, and then it will be here for you to easily understand the concept of basis in topology. The topology TC generated by C is the collection of union of elements of capital C. It can be shown that given a basis, TC indeed is a valid topology on X. And I told you that in previous example we have already seen that what are the conditions going to be satisfied and then for the formation of a basis. So this is that is also a matter of concern for you, and you should try to write that. Now, subspace topology is what you have to see this. Now, maps, homomorphism, and homotopy. Please try to write maps, 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 homomorphism, homomorphism, and homotopy. Again, I would like to say that you have gone through the concept of homomorphism and isomorphism in your linear algebra or in your abstract algebra, wherever it was, you have gone through that in your UG level syllabus. So let us see the maps, homeomorphism and homotopy is what. There are different definition of continuous functions. We give two equivalent ones below defined in a very general setting. This is the definition. Continuous function is what? Please write a neighborhood of a point. A neighborhood of a point, a small x belongs to capital X, is simply an open set of capital X. Is simply an open set of capital X containing a small x. A function f is mapping from x to y is continuous at small x belongs to capital X. If for any neighborhood V of fx, there is a neighborhood U, capital U, as written on the screen, you can see in this PDF, of x such that range of U is improper subset of V. And for the sake of convenience of understanding, you can see this figure. This is the illustration. This is the illustration of the continuity. Here you have taken U, X and capital X. You have taken here V, Fx, Y and Fq. The things that have been explained here have been taken in two different format. And this is the illustration of continuity. Equivalently, a function F is mapping from X to Y, or f is function from x to y, is continuous if for any open set V in Y, its premise f inverse V is also open. So students, I hope that you have got it and you have written this. Now, if you want to describe this concept in details, then we can take help of calculus, that how in the language of calculus this continuous function can be, you can say, explained, as you know from your differential calculus, that what is the concept of continuity of a function. You know that at a particular point for a function, if the left hand limit at a point and the right hand limit at the same point and the value of the function the same point at the same point are equal or identical, then means LHL is equal to RHL is equal to value of the function, means left hand limit is equal to right hand limit, and then you see left hand limit minus right hand limit and value of the function, if all are equal, then the function is supposed to be continuous at that very point. So in your topological space or in your topology, there is a very good importance of continuous function also. And it is your duty to explain these things, illustrate this function, and try to connect with the practical problem of topology. So homeomorphism, the most important concept to study topology is homeomorphism, which essentially say that two topological spaces are equivalent in the sense that they have the same connectivity. If the two topological spaces are equivalent in the sense that they have the same connectivity, then this concept is connecting to the concept of homeomorphism, and homeomorphism is the most important concept of study of topological space. So student, this session is powered by digital version 2.0 of Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University Jaipur, and in case of any query, you are asked that you write your comment in the inbox. I shall try to resolve your query from there. Thank you very much. Thanks once again.